the end of that block. The Nets are out of Brooklyn as they take on their Eastern Conference rival in today's game. We are nearly ready for...
Well, look,
great stuff, D.A., thanks. And tonight we got a couple of teams, both of them terrific from long range, and Doris, that's become such an emphasis in today's game. Would you agree with that?
I don't think there's any question. There's been a real devaluing of the mid-range or in-between game in the NBA. Most offenses seem to be driven toward shots at the rim or shots behind the three-point arc, and that's driven very much by what I would call this analytics generation. New owners who come from business, very numbers-driven. And listen, you know, depending on which organization you belong to, the emphasis on that situation is contingent on what the philosophy is. But there's no question that quality threes are important for most offenses in the league. Greg Popovich has said it. You simply can't win without shooting a high percentage from three.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. Setting the floor for the Nets. Brook Lopez is out there with Trevor Booker. Then it's Jeremy Lin. And it's Bogdanovich in at the three slot. A screen from Thompson. Smith outside. Cleveland moving it around for three. Love. That's in. Coming off the assist from Thompson. Love's got five now.
Well, Love has worked to diversify his game. You have to guard him from the perimeter or he will burn you.
Lopez outside. And a wide open look for Lin. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
The rapid-fire threes coming from everywhere.
Boy, both teams really attacking from downtown right now. This is a long-range battle at the moment.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop.
Let's hope that's never the plan, and certainly not this early in the game. You don't want to let him get on a roll. That can make a long night for you.
And Bogdanovich kicks to Lopez. Four on the clock. Let's it go from deep. Good D by Thompson. Cavaliers have gotten their first three shots to go in for to start off this game.
If you look at the Cavs offense, I think there's a lot to like. They can shoot it. They're sure-handed with the basketball, and they're very good at attacking the offensive glass.
Lin against Irving. Lin dishes to Lopez. Lopez missing again.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Took him no time at all on that one. And that's now 6 points for Kyrie Irving. Lin kicks to Lopez. Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. And he uses the glass on the layup. Lopez has got his first bucket of the night.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Irving passes to Love. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. Love's got a pair of threes now in the first quarter for the Cavs. Lin against Irving. Lopez right side. There's Lin with the three. Let's keep it alive. Bogdanovich dishes to Booker. Good work defensively by Smith.
Great possession with an even better shot. Disappointing it doesn't go.
The drive.
Oh. No. That is why the ticket price is what it is when LeBron is in town. Amazing dunk to finish the play.
Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. In the corner, it's Lin. Booker is screen on Love. Here's Lin. It's taken away by Smith. LeBron drives in. And a great job by the D contesting that shot and forcing the miss. Lin adds a two-pointer. And it comes off the front of the rim. And we reach the end of the first quarter. Cavaliers lead by... The second quarter just getting set to start. What stands out to you from the Cavaliers in this one?
You know, it's been a great display of team. team basketball here thus far.
You know, everything runs better when you're being unselfish. The reason they're piling up assists is because they're willing to pass until they find a good shot.
And Brooklyn, looking who they've got. We've got Bennett. Harris is out there with Whitehead. Then it's Brooke Lopez. And it's Hollis Jefferson in at the three. And for Irving last season, Doris, he limited his drives to the rim to try to protect his health.
Well, I think, Kevin, you know, you come back from a fractured kneecap in 2015 playoffs, you understand that mentality. Health has been a question. He's missed significant time to injury in the majority of his five NBA seasons, and I don't think this is a sign of things to come.
Andre Liggins, he's checked in for Irving. Randy Foy, he's checked in for the Nets. And Fry kicks to Shumpert. Second chance shot. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
And the veteran Fry just continues to build upon his fine career. A big man with a sweet touch from the distance.
And Channing Fry, a three-point specialist of 6'11". It's a shot he didn't really utilize in earnest until his fifth year in the league.
And think about it, Kevin. It's like he flipped the switch. It's become the staple of his offensive game. And he's a trendsetter in that regard. Very tough to defend that pick and pop at the top of the key.
There's the pick. Lopez a screen. And Harris wide open. He shoots. Can't capitalize on the good pick.
Regardless of that miss right there, that's a shot you want him taking. He practices that all the time. Makes a ton of them.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, Kyrie Irving is an elite offensive player at his position, but he's trying to improve his focus at the defensive end. He said, I was always that guy getting called out on film. You get tired of it after a while. It's all about effort. You want to be a guy that your teammates trust. And Kevin, we know that point guard is one of the most stocked positions in the league. They need Irving to stay locked in.
Definitely a lot of responsibility at that point guard position. They don't get many nights off. Absolutely not. Thanks, D.A.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Kicks to Foy. Takes the three. Cavaliers with the rebound. They put up a nice win against the Bucks the last time out.
And in that game, guys, they were just about as dominant defensively on the interior as you could ever be.
NBA coaches talk all the time about protecting the rim, and I thought they showed great anticipation and quickness to the ball all night.
Doris, we have some prolific big men right now in the game. Who is the best post player, you think, in the league?
I think, you know, surprisingly, and a guy who's not getting on national television too much, to me, it's DeMarcus Cousins. You're talking about a guy who can play with his back to the basket. It's going to require at least two defenders if you're going to try to check him. But he can also step away and make shots. What I'm anxious to see is, does DeMarcus Cousins mature, and does he ever get Sacramento to a place or go somewhere else where his game can be more well-known across the country?
Well said. Do you think he's as difficult to coach as it appears from a distance?
You know, I think he's a hyper-competitive guy, and whoever coaches him is going to have as strong a personality as he does.
Spoken like a former coach. Got a piece of it. Bennett kicks to Harris. Now the dish to Lopez. And stolen by Fry. Here's Liggins, covered by Foy. LeBron passes to Fry. Goes back up. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron.
The long arms of Fry really uses his length well inside.
The wide open look here for Lopez. And again, no good by Brooklyn.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
And that one, good.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Shumpert against Harris. They double him with Shumpert. Bennett, the Cavaliers pull it in. Fry's got three rebounds now in this one. And finished off by LeBron.
And they're not taking their foot off the pedal. They just keep adding to their lead.
Yeah, their focus, their toughness, energy, it's all been on the high end of the register, and they're being rewarded for it.
The feed to Lopez. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Lopez has got his second basket.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
And Randy Foy gets the whistle that time. draws his first foul.
Man, that's it's close, but you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
There's 18 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Basket counts. Dunleavy's got his first bucket in this one.
Well, you really have to be feeling it to go with the teardrop. That is not as easy as that looked.
Here's four. Dishes to Bennett. 1 second left. Oh, and he just knocked down the putt. So as we conclude the first half, so
it's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
First half in the books, Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome back. It's Cleveland out on top at halftime. They are way out in front, leading by 17. And let's go to Kenny. What'd you think of their first half?
Well, it has been an electric performance. These guys were firing on all cylinders. They came out aggressive.
And in a matter of moments, they'll be starting.
Welcome back to Cleveland, Ohio, home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. My wife and I toured that recently. It is worth the price of admission. Welcome back, everybody. Third quarter just about to get going here in what has been so far a runaway game. You look at Kyrie Irving in this game, he has been everywhere.
Always been a dynamic scorer, and we saw in that first half the entire repertoire on display.
Well, there are very few defenders who can check him one-on-one, and in fact, collectively, he's a challenge for defenses.
Love and Thompson, the hard rebounding post pair. Smith and LeBron filling out the wings, and it's Irving at the one spot. That's the five for Cleveland right now. Nets trail by 17. And you know, there was so much excitement surrounding the Nets when they finished the new arena in Brooklyn in 2012. They traded for Paul Pierce and Kevin Garnett to try to fast track their success. But that win now strategy really failed.
Yeah, and that's what can happen when you mortgage your future. Short-term goals can lead to that long-term misery. And they still have some pieces they can build around. We'll see what additional talent they can attract going forward.
Nice shot by Smith.
And they've had assists now on their last three baskets.
Here's the screen. To the middle. Got a piece of it. Oh, and here we go. Irving's got it. The fast break chance. And here's Love for three. Thompson with the bucket. Thompson's got his first 2 points of the night.
Plus eight in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
A chance here to get a quick injury report.
Hi, guys. The hit.
That's how we play the game. Bring it in. Let's go.
After taking a look, he informed me that it doesn't look too bad. Of course, the schedule is getting extremely demanding at this time of the season, and that injury is only going to make things worse. Kevin?
All right, David, and folks, we will, of course, keep everyone updated as we find out more.
And you know what? He could have a long road ahead in terms of getting back on the court. But one thing we all know, he's never been shy of hard work.
Yeah, his fortitude is tremendous. He's going to keep rehabilitating at the highest level until he's back out there with his teammates.
And count it. That's 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line. That's good.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Whitehead's checked in for the Nets. Cleveland shooting their third free throw shot of the game. And, you know, certainly the culture of the NBA and basketball has seen some shifts over the last couple decades. Doris, when you look at the game today, how do you think it's changed? And where do you think it's going?
But I think from a strategy standpoint, the biggest change in the NBA culture is that it's going smaller and faster. It's trending toward positionless players where guys can shift among three, four positions at a time. And then the other part of the neat thing is in this day and age of social media, from the off-the-court stuff, we're starting to see these guys become fashion icons.
Lopez a screen. Here's Bogdanovich. Hits the target from 18 feet.
Oof, that is a tough shot.
For Cleveland, they've gone 4-6 from the field since the start of the third. Here's Love. It's deflected, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Booker. And the Nets making a change here. Bennett's checked in.
Bennett. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Outside Irving, six to shoot. Out to Smith from downtown. That shot is off. So Brooklyn will take it the other way. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
Yeah, they really had a breakdown, I thought, in that third quarter. Just got a little too lax, didn't take care of the basketball, and going from being in total control to handing it over like they did, never a good feeling.
And Cleveland making a change here. Shumpert's checked in, and a switch here for Brooklyn. Harris has checked in. The Nets working the ball around now. Here's Whitehead, looking for his first basket still in this one. But they recover it. In the corner, it's Harris. Softly drops in the floater. And so it's Cleveland with it. Just 4 points, that's all they've given up here in the second half. And that one's good, Shumpert.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Pass to Bennett. Here's Kilpatrick. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Kilpatrick's got his second basket of the game. Irving kicks to Jefferson. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Irving's got 5 assists tonight.
And certainly, they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
Kilpatrick, he dents the rim with a two-handed slam.
Wow.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finish hard with two hands on that stuff. The screen from Thompson. Irving dishes to Thompson. To the paint. Here's Whitehead, and he floats in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
And no matter what they've tried, the D just has not been able to deny them the ball inside.
And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been Welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail biter here, but you never know. And for the Nets, they're shooting pretty good tonight at 48%. On the court for the Nets, getting the fourth quarter going. We've got Bogdanovich. Brook Lopez is out there with Booker. Then it's Jeremy Lin. And it's Hollis Jefferson in at the shooting guard position.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
James kicks to Dunleavy. Rebound, Brooklyn.
Got to be stronger about finishing those looks. That's a great opportunity, guys.
Indeed it is. You're right, Doris. What do you think is the most difficult thing about being a rookie that they have to face, Doris, in the transition from the college game to the pro game?
Now, I'm interested in your response as well. I mean, the first two things that come to mind for me are physicality and length of season. Do you think that those are probably the two toughest adjustments?
Absolutely. But I also think that intangible is that being a what's it mean to be a professional? Because don't you think it covers the way you handle your off time, the way you practice, interact with the press? I mean, it's so multidimensional. Learning to be a pro just does not happen overnight.
Is there any better compliment in any field than to have someone say, that's a pro right there?
The best. Agreed. The best. Bogdanovich passes to Lin. It's hauled in by LeBron. James has got 3 rebounds so far in the game.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Yeah, when Kyrie is heating up here, it is.
Great job, guys. Nice work. Take a seat now. Let's talk.
He's got a lot of miles on him. Some studies have shown players who come to the league at a young age and, Doris, play a lot of minutes end up experiencing earlier and sharper declines in their 30s. Do you think that could be the case for LeBron?
Well, obviously, Kevin, we've seen him deal with some back issues over the course of his career. He took that mid-season break back in 2015, the longest absence of his career. But listen, come on, LeBron's been an iron man. He's learning to pick his spots and to manage some of that wear and tear.
The Cavaliers leading by 18. Irving with the ball. And it's Lin picking him up. Irving dishes to Thompson. It's a pick by Love. James kicks to Thompson. To the middle. Whoops, anticipated the pass. Turnover. Bogdanovich passes to Lynn. 1:56 left in the fourth quarter.
Almost seemed like he was overthinking that shot. Such a wide open look.
To the inside. Here's Bogdanovich. Lynn dishes to Booker. Doris, we know you were a standout point guard in the Big East for Providence. What players do you feel have a similar approach to the point guard position that you played so well in the NBA now?
Well, I was not your necessarily traditional setup point guard. I was a player who liked to get to the rim and get to the free throw line a ton. So I would say somebody like Kyrie Irving, who wants to be a dynamic scorer, handle is there. So I didn't mind passing, Kevin, but I wanted to score it too.
See, I picture you as like a Chris Paul. Leaner.
Yeah.
Could do both equally well. You could dish as well as anybody, but drive as well as anybody too.
I'll tell you,
you're probably being modest here.
I'm not being modest. I was pretty tough too. You didn't like to play against me.
But I like broadcasting with you.
Back at you.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for the Cavaliers.
A beautiful pass doesn't always get you on the highlight reels, but there were some spectacular dishes in this game.
But you know what? It was a team that was in sync and just trusted one another to take the right shots.
And so looking at their number, this will be win number 22 on the year.
And this is a great way for them to kick off this season series. Two more games ahead, and they've taken the mental advantage with this win tonight. I mean, when you look at the stats, you'll see just how dominant a game this was for Irving.
I really thought his playmaking fueled the energy for them tonight. His teammates were confident that they'd get the ball when they were ready, and really nice job making his guys comfortable.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Channing Frye's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Jefferson comes in for LeBron. Iman Shumpert has checked in for Smith. And it's DeAndre Liggins in for Kyrie Irving.
And this run not really doing them any good at this point, as late as it's starting to evolve.
Well, they know they've lost this one, but this is still valuable time to try and work out some of their issues.
And Rondae Hollis-Jefferson started out strong last season as a rookie, then had the injury to the ankle that kind of derailed his development. Came in, though, providing lockdown defense, which most scouts expected. I think the surprise may have been his shooting number. And what that tells me is that he has a really good understanding of who he is as a player. That is very difficult for young players to accomplish. They always tend to spend their time trying to prove to you what they can't do.
Jefferson with a three. The rebound by Bennett. And DeAndre Liggins picks up the foul. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, that's a bad move there. Stops the clock and puts the other side on the line.
He hits the second from the line. And so it's Cleveland taking care of business in this one. Some good moments throughout this one.
Thanks very much, Kyrie. Nice win tonight. What was your thought process coming into the game?
I was just going out there trying to compete on every play, trying to play as much defense as possible. Just sticking to our game plan. We had a game plan going in, and we executed.
Got it done at both ends of the floor, Kyrie. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.